Grade 4 Math, Number 1, Regroup Hundreds and Tens. We're going to be doing that today. We're going to be regrouping hundreds and tens. So first, let's take a look at what we've got here. I've got 15 pennies right here. See? 5, 10, 15. 15 pennies. Which is the same thing as having 15 ones, isn't it? Even though we can see a 10 here and a 5 here, it's still 15 ones because we're grouping them all together as if we were putting both the 1 and the 5 in the ones place. You can do that when you're converting amounts of money and regrouping. Let's take a look over here. Now we've got dimes. Dimes are 10 cents each, and we have got 4, 8, 12 dimes. Well, each one of these is a 10. Each dime is a 10. So 12 dimes is 12 tens. But it's also 120 ones. If we were to count how many ones are here, it's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120. So 12 tens is also 120 ones, just like the pennies over here. But you can also see the 12 tens. If we leave the ones place alone, we've got 12 tens. So, come along with me and we're going to be doing that. 200 is the same as how many tens? Well, just cover up the ones place and it'll tell you. See that? It's 20 tens. 100 is the same as how many tens? Well, 10 times 10 is 100, and if we cover up the ones place, we see the 10. See that? So 100 is the same thing as 10 tens. How about 500? Can you cover up the ones place and tell me how many tens there are? There's 50 tens. Okay. Let's try these. Each one of these is 100. Sort of like a dollar bill is 100 pennies. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 hundred. To find out how many tens we have, we take away the ones place, and that tells us we've got 40 tens. 400 is the same thing as 40 tens. Here's 600s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Take away the ones place. See? We've got 60 tens. Okay, now let's try doing it with some ones, with some smaller tens in it, I mean. We've got 100 and 100. That's 200. And now we've got three little tens here. 200s and 3 tens. That would be 230. 100, 200, 210, 220, 230. It's also 23 tens. See? Cover up the ones place. It's 23 tens. Let's look at this one. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 hundreds. See? And we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tens. 400s and 6 tens is 460. That's if we put each number separately into its own place value. But how many tens is it? It's 46. If we cover up the ones place, we can see there's 46. Now I'll show you on a place value chart how we're doing that. Okay? So, here's the hundreds, here's the tens, and here's the ones. We're putting the 2 and the 0 into the tens place, and then a 0 in the ones place, to get 20 tens for 200. Normally you would put a 2 here, a 0 here, and a 0 here. But what we did was we grouped them all together in the tens place. The ones kept their place with one digit in it, like it was supposed to. But then everything else went into the tens column to get 20 tens. 60 tens is 600. Instead of putting the 6 in the hundreds place, we stuck it in the tens place together
with the 0. Normally it would be 600, and we made it 60 tens. Now look. Now we've got 46 tens. Normally the 4 would be in the hundreds place. See? 400, 60 is 460. But we put them together in the tens place. The ones kept their single digit like they were supposed to, and then we grouped the other numbers together in the tens place. Did you know that you could say 1,320 is 132 tens? Yeah, you could. You could say that. So, that's how you regroup hundreds and tens, and you put them all into the tens column. See that? So, I'll see you next video. We're in fourth grade now. Follow along.